Yeah, your boy Fist in the his house, bringing another great edition of Call of Duty Ghost for me to you, because that's what I do. PS4 Ground War Team Deathmatch. I think this is Breakout, Prison Break, something like that. Yep. So, anyways, the thing about the PS4 versus the Xbox One is that you can't hide from nobody. You can't, like, the thing about it is they want you to game with people. So I accept everybody's friends request. I don't really care. So you get in the game, you know, you got to have your beast weapons. It kind of brings it back to old school when you're playing against people and you want to get your game out. You ain't trying to hide from nobody. I ain't scared. Let's go. Bring it, son. Bring it. So I brought out this 45 more damage with the red dot, get my game on. So, you know, Twitter is an awesome place. I think Twitter is the best forums in the whole entire world as far as instantaneous information. And if you, and you know, today's news is this, basically Complexity, they didn't want to lose their team because the team was going to bail on them anyway. And so what they did was, I think Complexity, based on what Doc Holliday was saying, that they probably asked for more money, and because they're never going to be beat, you know, Complexity, the team was never going to be beaten. They asked for more money, they didn't get it. So Complexity flipped the script and was like, yo, we're going to sell the team to Evil Genius for $70,000. So those four players got sold for 70 grand, and Evil Genius had to pay them what they wanted. Because the way I look at it right now is MLG is scared to make moves. MLG is scared to make moves, scared to, you know, change the game. You know, you know how you have a commissioner in sports to keep shit even and running perfectly and changing things and being excited. And they're scared. You know, to me, this is what they should do. And I had predicted that teams are going to get sold. Teams are going to be sold. Brand names are going to be sold. They didn't sell the brand name. They sold the team. There's a difference. So, like, Optic has a great brand name. They sell t-shirts, the name, blah, blah, blah. It's probably worth about $1 million, something like that. They could probably, the team isn't worth probably about $25,000 at best. But I would probably sell the name brand is probably worth more. Hex probably get way more money for that. So, anyways, moving right along, you're gonna have to make these moves in the future because there's people with bigger money that's gonna come along and buy these pro teams. But here's what I would do to, like, stop all that nonsense, because as it stands right now, Complexity was sold to Evil Genius. They got a bigger contract for whatever money they're getting, and nobody's gonna beat Evil Genius. I don't care how many times. Basically, Evil Genius, ex-Complexity players, the rest of the pro players out there that are practicing 60, 70 hours a week, they're basically pub teams. They're never, ever going to beat Evil Genius. Never. Mark my video. Mark it down. The only way they're going to beat them is if Evil Genius is going to break up. And they're not. They're in a driver's seat. And MLG is not changing anything. So you're not going to see nothing happen over there. And here's what I would do. If I was MLG and I was running the show at MLG, I would turn it into a social event. It's getting to the point right now, the teams, you're too scared to make a move on the pro teams because you don't want them to do something else or leave or start their own league. You're too scared to make a move on them, so why don't you take the money that you're jacking people from on advertisement fees and just tour the team and bring on a social event. Socialize the experience with the teams just playing each other and not having the team stress out, you know what I mean? It's just, you know who the best teams are, and just do it like an N1. You have the bottom team. If you want to try out for the touring team, you got to beat the bottom teams. If you beat the bottom teams, you get into the group. And that's it. That's all you have to do. It's not complicated. If you're too scared to make moves on the team and, like, create competition and actually make it a sport, then forget it. Just tour it. Turn it into a social event. Bring out some music and have some fun and make it, you know, have a good ass experience with gaming. That's what I would do. You know, I mean, don't bring, hire my ass on an MLG. I'll make it bigger than Woodstock every event. My ass would be bigger than PAX. They don't get it. They don't know what to do. Look, the bottom line is you want to get views. You want to jack the advertisers for money on views. That's all about numbers. Bring me aboard. I'll make it happen. Boom. The biggest social. I will bring COD back to life, even though it's a shitty game, because they don't want to put me over at Activision. So the next best thing is MLG. I'll make it a social event. If you get the social event big enough to where people are going to the event, then you can change the game from the outside in. That's your back door into changing the game for Activision, because they're not going to listen to you unless you prove yourself. And I have a lot of great ideas, but nobody, you know, nobody wants to give me a shine, because I'll take piece of that. I'll take over their job. They know it. Period. Because my ideas are the bazillion times better, and I can implement it. I'm a boss. Period. So don't be scared to call me if you're a studio, MLG, whatever. I'm not scared. I'm not scared to take chances. I'm not scared to change shit, make it happen. Boom, excited. I've been on the forum since 2006. My ear is to the ground. I know what's going on. Bottom line. And you said accept it. That's how great I'm. I predict stuff and it happens. I told you teams are going to get sold. It happens. I told you what's going to happen in the games. It happens. I tell you which games are going to flop. It happens. I mean, bottom line is I knew Titanfall wasn't going to make it based off the beta. But I was trying to hype it up because I wanted a game to beat Call of Duty. And I, in deep down inside, I knew that Titanfall wasn't going to make it. And people say, oh, you predicted the call, this was going to change the game. In a sense, it did. Because now you see exoskeleton suits that are in Call of Duty, like climbing walls and jetpack jumping. That is a direct response of Activision to the parkour in the Titanfall game. That is a direct response. And I don't care what they say. The game was in development 2 years. T-Martin, those guys, they don't know what the hell they're talking about. That's a direct response to that game. I could change the industry. If one company picks me up with some money, it's over for everybody else. Guaranteed fact. Pick me up. Pick me up. Pass go. Let's do this. And so anyways, that's my commentary for today. I'm going to be covering some Killzone 2 on Fist 2. And I'm starting MLB The Show on the PS4. Other news too. Star Wars Battlefront is going to be shown at E3, as well as the new Mortal Kombat 10. Until next time, it's your boy Fist. Peace! I'm out.